Oh, happy day. Happy Tuesday. I can't even explain how I'm so disappointed in myself via how I'm doing in school. Honey, I'm not even... I've always made A's and B's. So to see myself like at C's and about to get a D, it's like... What is the matter? I don't know. I'm telling you, I used to love school. I mean, I could bust out a 12-page paper like in 2 hours, 2.5 hours tops, literally, just off the top of my head. May have to flip to get some citations corrected or added, but now, today is Tuesday, okay? Oh gosh, that's how out of it I am. Wait, what's today? Okay, yeah, today is Tuesday. It just felt like it was Wednesday for a second. But, I'm just so not there. My paper was due Sunday at midnight. Today's Tuesday. What does that tell you? Ask me how much of it do I have done. I'm just so not into school, and like I said before in the previous videos, I'm just tired of getting these degrees and they're in my box because I'm not even in the field that I'm supposed to be in, you know, blah. Just so many things are changing and transitioning. Sometimes I don't know, no, not sometimes, most of the time, as far as career wise how things have changed, the economy has changed, and career paths kind of make you go a different direction. I don't know what I want to do. I want, can someone tell me what I'm supposed to be doing, you know? Before it was like, okay, I knew what I was supposed to be doing, ministry, and then secularly. Now, then it turned into, okay, I know what I'm supposed to do, like, in a secular world, like as far as career paths, had all down packed, and then the ministry stuff was on my nerves because God allowed me to discover a lot, see a lot, wolves in sheep clothing, and I'm just not talking about leadership, just like people in general. And then he took me on a sabbatical from just ministry things, and then. Now that I finally, it's like an aha moment. That car should turn. Now I'm like, oh, now I see. See, I should have went that way. I see like, oh wow, okay. Now I see why you had me doing certain things, why you had me at certain places. Now I see what I'm supposed to be doing via ministry, and you know, rest. You can rest and work at the same time. Because if I see, my sister would make fun of me every time I had an idea or, you know, was a part of a ministry. And, you know, it's like the spirit of an apostle. You see the need and you fix it. You may not fix it, but you'll show them how to fix it and be like, okay, love you, bye. Here's a blueprint, now someone else build it. And she's always like, oh my gosh, like, you know, you get in that mode. And it's like project, you know, and I'll be doing like 5-6 different projects, you know, for one ministry or ministries. And now I have a balance and a better understanding as far as how to operate in that gift. Now, as far as on the secular side, I'm like, oh, Jesus, yeah, what am I supposed to be doing, Lord? I have no idea. Okay, this truck is like way on my nerves. But anywho, I want to say, where is my career path? Like, what am I supposed to be doing? I don't even know what I want to do anymore. I mean, like, in a perfect world, of course, like I stated before, I always wanted to have, like, my own domestic violence, transitional housing program for women and kids, something for single parents, a Christian summer camp that would go from June to September. And of course, I want a charter school named after my father. And the emphasis would be computers, English, science, and politics. So, I don't know what the Lord is going to have me doing. I still have on like books and books of ideas and, you know, but to, I'm waiting for God's favor, His timing, because, you know, to make money, you got to have money. And all these ideas I have, I don't want to put all this money in all these ideas. And, you know, each idea as a startup is like $2,500, and things don't pan out, and you need match money and sponsorship, and honey, I don't know. All right, people. I'll talk to you later. Bye-bye.